on this deep level of understanding crisis, we could say that crisis is a new arrangement of flow and structure. Universe is a result of structures. There are structures, and there is always flow, free flow of things. I mean, balance in nature is always balance between structure and flow. Structure and flow. It's like water. Imagine we pour water on the floor. If there are no structure, no objects on the floor, the water will go spread and will produce an homogeneous surface. Homogeneous surface means no interaction of energy, death, it's entropy. But if there are objects, the water comes. Sometimes it, like a tsunami, takes the object with it, but sometimes goes around. And in the round, it's a lot of turbine things happening here. These new things happening here produce new structures, new elements. This is how life emerged, they say. Life emerged when flow stroke to structure, like the waves of the sea falling on rocks. So we can see crisis as an attempt of our system to find a new balance for structure and flow. Only that the flow in the beginning is so strong that it takes down our structure. And we must be patient enough to permit new structures to be built. So this means crisis, it's very deep thing, and we can never see it superficially, and it takes our wholeness. This is why we must give time to crisis, to flow, to permit our new structures to be born, to be created. Stay with it, trust the process. Stay with it, it means give time, give all this. Stay, follow, be honest with yourself, be aware of your needs, be aware of what's happening to you. And trust the process means trust the change. Anyway, there is no stability in the universe. All is changing all the time. Something will happen. Maybe not full happiness, but still different experience from now. It's good to find a balance, even temporarily balance, between flow and structure. Flow and our new structure. There are moments that in crisis we are lost in this sense of nothingness, of vagueness, of fog. This is total flow. But we must create little islands of structure. Practically, this means little routines. Little routines are very, very helpful. no matter our pain, no matter our sorrow, it's very, very useful to create little routines in order to facilitate the balance between structure and flow. Because just flow can very easily lead to helplessness and freezing, which is very, very bad situation. And if we stay long in freezing and in helplessness, then we may have permanent damage. And also we must connect with this flow and structure, the balance in our mind and intuition. What I say is that we think much sometimes, but also a lot of us, we are very intuitive persons. We feel a lot of things, just like that, grasp it, not concrete meanings. So we must create a balance between thinking and feeling. In crisis, we need both, because thinking gives structure, offers structure, and feeling offers flow. Thank you.